See this question. This question asked in GATE 2009. They are saying, consider a memory system that contains 8 memory modules. They are attached to the system bus, which is 1 word length. When a write request is made, the bus is occupied for 100 nanoseconds with address data and control information. Thereafter, addresser memory module takes 500 nanoseconds for storing the word. If module internal operations are overlapped, then what will be the maximum number of requests can be granted in 1 millisecond? They are asking, see, they are given, they are saying they have 8 memory modules. They are saying decoder takes, so for decoding it takes 100 nanoseconds. For accessing modules, it takes 500 nanoseconds. If you are overlapped, then in 1 million seconds, how many requests you can generate? See, they are saying, so module reference, and word reference. So they are given module reference will be 100 nanoseconds. And word reference will be, they are given 500 nanoseconds. So module reference is nothing but decoder. So decoder take 100 nanoseconds in order to decode, in order to give the module number. So it is going to give modules. They are saying you have around 8 memory modules. Module 0, module 1, module 2, and module 7. This is module 0, this is module 1, this is module 2, this is module 7. They are saying you have around 7 modules are there. So this decoder, it is going to give every module, you will get the, so after that you will get the data. So see, you understand. So they are saying module reference will be 100 nanoseconds. So in order to access module, it requires 500 nanoseconds. So in order to access decoder takes around 100 nanoseconds. So this is, they want to say decoder take 100 nanoseconds and module takes 500 nanoseconds. They are said you have around 8 modules. If you overlap, then how many requests you can ask in 1 millisecond? They are asking, if you can overlap, how many requests you can ask in 1 millisecond? Let us see, we can overlap or not. If we are overlap, then we can say. If we are not overlap, then that is not possible. See, we cannot give the request. We will solve. So for 100 nanoseconds, for the first request it takes 100 nanoseconds. For the decoder it takes 100 nanoseconds, and after that 500 nanoseconds for first request. Not to access first module, you require 100 nanoseconds, and in order to access that module, you require 500 nanoseconds. This 100 nanoseconds is for, the decoder. Decoder takes 100 nanoseconds. This 500 nanoseconds for, so that module takes 500 nanoseconds. After that, this is for module 0. After that, you are giving another request, 100 nanoseconds. See, once it is free, the decoder is free. Here, after 100 nanoseconds, after second request, it takes 100 nanoseconds for decoder. After 100 nanoseconds, decoder is free. Now it is going for another request, third request, 100 nanoseconds. See, here also 100 nanoseconds, decoder is free. Now decoder is asking for another request, 100 nanoseconds. So now here also decoder is free. After here, the at this point of time, decoder is free. 100 plus 100 plus 100. You can ask for another request. 1, 2, 3, 4. See, after 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, after 500 nanoseconds, after completing, so this take 100, 500 nanoseconds. This take 500 nanoseconds. This take 500 nanoseconds. This take 500 nanoseconds. This take 500 nanoseconds. See, this is for memory module 0, module 1. This is for module 2. This is for module 3. This is for module 4. This is for module 5. Still you have 3 more modules are there. Still you have 2 more modules are there. Module 6 will be free. Module 7 will be free. See, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100. So 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. At the completion of the first request, at the end of the first request, you may ask 5 requests. See, 100, 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. Okay? 500. After completion of the first request, you can ask, at the end of the first request, you can ask 5 requests. So, even though you ask 5 requests, you have still 2 more resources are free. You are using M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5. Still M6 will be free, M7 will be free. Once this is over, this request is over, this access is over, it is going to free. After that, you can access, you have 3 more resources. Right, after this is over, after 5 requests, you have two more modules are there. You can ask 2 modules, even though completed here, this is going to free. First request will be free. Now you have 3 modules. 6 will be there, 7 will be there, and module 0 will be free. So you can overlap. Now you can overlap. Okay, once you overlap, they are asking if you overlap, then how many requests you can ask in 1 milliseconds. You got my point, right? Now you can overlap. At the end of the first request, you can ask 5 requests. Even though you ask 5 requests, module 6 and 7 it is going to be free. Even though you have module 6 and 7, module 0 is going to be free. At the end of the 5 requests, you have 3 free modules are there. Okay, that's why you can overlap. So for 100 nanoseconds, so for 100 nanoseconds, you can ask 1 request. For every 100 nanoseconds, you can ask for 1 request. Why you can ask? Because you can overlap. So for every 1 second, you can ask 100 into 10 to the power minus 9 request you can ask. For every 1 second, you can ask 1 by 100 into 10 to the power minus 9 request. So for every 1 millisecond, you can ask 10 to the power minus 3 by 100 into 10 to the power minus 9. Right? So for every 1 millisecond, you can ask, if it is 9 is going to up, it will be 10 to the power 9 minus 3, 6, 10 to the power 6. So you can ask 10 to the power 4. 10 to the power 4 request you can ask. For every 1 millisecond, you can ask 10 to the power 4 request. Okay, you understand? First, you have to check we are overlapping or not. Yes, we can overlap because we have enough resources to overlap. We have around 8 resources are there. For every, at the end of first request, first module, at the end of the first request, we may, ask for 5 more requests. Even though we ask 5, still 2 more resources are going to be free. That is M6 it will be free and M7 it will be free. Even though 2 are free, the first request, For M0, we asked for M0, right? At first, that is also going to be free. We have three more resources are there. So you have enough resources to overlap. That's where I am checking for 1 millisecond, how many requests you can ask. For every 100 nanoseconds, I can ask one request. For 1 second, I can ask 1 by 100 into 10 to the power 9 requests I can ask. For means 100, I can, you know, I transferred. N means 10 to the power 9. That's why I transferred here, 10 to the power 9. Okay. For 1 millisecond, it will be 10 to the power 3. 1 M means 10 to the power 3. So, for 1 millisecond, I can ask 10 to the power 4 requests.